Too much sex.
Everybody, wash your hands. Cover your mouth when you cough. If you are sick, stay home.
Die quickly.
And now?
John and Ken Show. John Cobell and Ken Champeau. KFI AM 640. I love it. It's just got the perfect... he should tour with them.
That's not true.
He died, though, right? The Warren Zevon? Oh, a while ago.
Suck it in.
You know how much we owe as taxpayers here in California? If you add up all the money that the state government and all the local governments owe, it comes to $1.3 trillion.
And this goes to June 30th, 2015, so this is a year and a half ago, huh?
Write that down, 1.3, and then add 11 zeros. This is all the money that we've borrowed through bonds, all the money we've borrowed through regular loans, all the unfunded pensions that we owe, and health care benefits, and just everything.
Everything.
Every dollar that has to be paid out sometime. And in a lot of cases, sometime soon. $1.3 trillion, that is a number that is difficult for most people to comprehend, but that is the tsunami of debt that California is facing. To talk about this is Marc Joffe. He's director of policy research at the California Policy Center.
Yep, and they sent us this report today, and we thought it'd be a good chance to talk about it, since we often talk about the wall of debt that we face with governments. Let's get him on.
Marc, thank you for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
How do you get the average person listening now in their car to understand $1.3 trillion? That is such an enormous number.
I don't have the statistics on how many pennies that would, how high the mountain of pennies would be. It probably would go all the way to the moon and past. But one way to think about it is in terms of comparing it to the state's share of gross domestic product.
Yeah.
It's more than half. So we have a 52% debt to gross state product ratio in the state.
So all the
federal.
All the income we generate in this state, we already owe more than half of what we make in a single year.
Yes.
How does this compare to other states, other countries? Are we in worse shape, better shape, same shape?
Well, you know, when you add up our share of the federal debt, and that's the 73% debt to GDP ratio at the federal level, and some people calculate it different ways. You can sometimes see 103%, but just using the more conservative estimate, if you take that 73% federal and you add it to the 52% state, taxpayers really have 125% debt to GDP ratio they're looking at. And that puts us on a par with Italy and Portugal, two countries that had massive financial crises back in 2011 and 2012.
Right, so, but we're not
in a good place.
We're not at Greece level yet, are we? Or...
No, Greece is up around 175, so we've got a ways to go.
And I like the way in this chart you guys actually pointed out what the debt is per individual in the state, with our population at about 39 million and the taxpayers at about 17 million.
Yeah, exactly. So that's $33,000 per person and $74,000 per taxpayer.
Realistically, this can't be paid off.
Right. We can hope that we can grow our way out of it, but population growth in California has been pretty low compared to other states. Another thing we can hope is that maybe the federal government will print up a lot of money and devalue this debt through inflation, but that has a lot of negative side effects,
like we're seeing
in Venezuela.
Yeah, what are some of the big sources of this debt? Give people an idea, because since it's the whole California government debt, what kind of debt are we talking about?
So you mentioned the three categories. The bonds and loans are $426 billion. The employee retirement or the employee health care is $148 billion. And then the big kahuna is the pensions, and we measure that at $713 billion. So it's adding up all the systems, CalPERS, CalSTRS, and so forth.
So more than half of the debt is pension to government workers?
Yeah, and when you add in the retirement health benefits, which is the same thing, it's going the same.
Oh, no, you're right. Yeah, folks, it is the same.
You're over $850 billion. So it's really 2/3 are going to those people.
And government workers make up what percentage of the state?
Well, I think it's on the range. I know the state workers are about 1% only, but local is more. So I'm just guessing, you know, probably in the range of 3-5%.
Okay, so we're looking at 2/3 of all the money we owe is for the 5% of government workers.
Yeah.
Statewide, right.
Their pensions and health care benefits.
Governments and city governments and local governments.
And we spend almost nothing on the roads and bridges and tunnels and the water supply, the water infrastructure.
Yes, exactly. There's hundreds of billions of dollars in deferred maintenance. We haven't been building new reservoirs. We're having trouble, you know, especially in Southern California, with having enough drinkable water.
Yeah.
There's a lot of resistance to building desalination plants.
I want to connect dots for people to understand that this is not just an advanced mathematics exercise here, where you have economists throwing around billions and trillions of dollars and percentages of GDP. But we've got $850 billion in pensions and health care benefits that we owe retired government workers, which are maybe 5% of the population. And we've spent hardly anything on the roads that everyone's driving on right now that's crumbling all over the place. Traffic backed up everywhere. There's not much of a useful public transit system in Los Angeles. We've already gone through the whole water supply crisis over the last 6 years. All this money is going for pensions and health care. Nothing's going for the stuff we need to exist as a society.
Exactly.
Yeah, actually, you guys point that out. This report does not include the cost of what they call deferred maintenance of the state's civil infrastructure. In 2015... there was a report by California Forward that estimated the state faces a $358 billion infrastructure funding gap over the next 10 years. That's also an enormous number.
When did it all start going south? Was there a time where California, where the state government was making rational decisions on how to allocate the money?
Well, I think this has really been a long time in coming. I think you'd find that the state's always been pretty generous with its spending, and I think the problem has really been that the growth has stopped keeping up with it. So, you know, in the 80s and 90s, the population growth started leveling off, and so this debt continued to accumulate, and yet we didn't have more and more taxpayers coming in to cover it.
And I don't think you covered this in your report, but I wonder what these numbers would have looked like, particularly when we're talking about the pension obligations, had we not had that 1999.com bubble deal that gave out such great pension deals to a lot of state employees that was copied by many local governments, which made these pension obligations leap in the last 15 years.
Yes, and you know, there are 50,000 retired employees, state and local, who get pensions of over $100,000 now.
Oh.
Including a guy that I think you've been covering recently, Leroy Baca. His pension and retiree health benefits in 2015 were $342,000.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he does have a real good deal.
$342,000?
That's what we're paying Baca in retirement.
Is he going to get paid if he goes to jail?
Yes.
I think they're debating that, aren't they?
Yeah.
I forget what the laws are, but I don't know that we can grab that pension from him.
Is there a day of reckoning? Is there a day when this doesn't work and something bad happens?
Well, you know, we've seen that in Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico hit the wall last year. They've defaulted. They can't get any more money from bondholders. They've had to make drastic cuts in public services, and you know, everybody's not real happy there. And there's been federal involvement as well. They really lost the ability to govern their own commonwealth because the federal government has now come in and said, we've got to approve your budget. You know, something like that could happen in California. If we asked for a federal bailout, we would lose our sovereignty as well.
Is there a mechanism for the federal government to take over our our budget?
Our finances, yeah.
No, I'd never heard of that. I didn't know.
No, that was specifically designed for territories.
Mm-hmm.
they'd have to come up with a new bankruptcy law for states. States cannot declare bankruptcy like cities can.
All right. Hey, Mark, thanks for coming on with us.
Great. Thanks for having me.
Mark Joffe, Director of Policy Research at the California Policy Center.
It's good stuff, even if it's grim stuff. Again, the total state and local government debt for California is $1.3 trillion. I just want to unpack this again. Driving in your car right now, if you're a taxpayer, and there's less and less these days in California, isn't there? $73,917 is your debt, each one of you listening, for that $1.3 trillion. That's how much you owe, the wall of debt. More coming up.